Vibe coding tools are popping up like mushrooms, and for anyone trying to get started, the sheer number of options doesn't really help. In this video, we'll explore the most popular tools for vibe coding, whether you're an experienced developer or a total beginner who has never written a line of code. We'll also touch on pricing, risks, and limitations. If you like a PDF summary of this video, check the video description. No email sign up, no clickbait, just the facts. Let's start with low-code or no-code tools, perfect for beginners. Tools like Lovable, Bolt, V0 from Vercel, Replit, or Tempo will fall in this category. You never heard of them? Don't worry, most people haven't. They're all browser-based, so you don't need to install anything, and getting started is ridiculously easy. These tools are mainly used for building frontends, making them ideal for quick prototypes and MVPs. Got a screenshot, a Figma design, or a sketch, you can often use it to guide the AI. Some tools even let you plug in backend services like Supabase or add Stripe for payments. Hosting is included, so you can go from idea to a working app without leaving your browser. There are a ton of options out there, but if you're unsure where to start, I would give Lovable a try. Now, if you ever run a Hello World script locally, you're already a hacker. That means you probably want a bit more flexibility, and here you have three options. Full IDEs, practically VS Code forks, extensions for your existing IDE, and CLI-based tools. So let's break it down. Full IDEs, Cursor and Windsurf are the most popular options. There's also Trey from ByteDance, the makers of TikTok, which is currently free. These tools look like Visual Studio Code, but come supercharged. Their standout feature, the agentic mode. It can create files, run commands, debug, and commit code with minimal input from you. Basically, it's like having a junior developer who never sleeps and doesn't ask for coffee breaks. Then we have extensions for IDEs. Think GitHub Copilot, Codeium, now Windsurf, Augment Code, Clin, Kodi, RuCode, Amazon Q, and many, many, many more. I don't have enough space on this slide. This work with your existing setup and provide agentic AI support while you code. And finally, CLI-based tools. It's relatively a small category. Codex CLI from OpenAI is probably one of the latest additions, but definitely worth a look. You can build something with these tools right now. But if you want a bit of guidance, I've created a course that walks you through everything step by step. I will show you how to build apps faster and what you need to know to do it right. For the last three categories mentioned, one exciting development here is MCP, a new protocol that lets these AI agents interact with external services. You can literally tell an agent to work on a ticket and close it when it's done. Wild, wild stuff. But what's the catch? Well, let's talk money for a second. Most of these tools aren't free. Running AI models is expensive, and those costs are being passed on to users. Still, many tools offer free trials or limited free tiers. If you're on a budget, you'll need to shop around. But with a bit of digging, you can find something free and still usable. But be sure to read the fine print. Some free plans require you to share your prompts or code base to help improve the AI. And limits on prompts and model quality are quite common. Realistically though, if these tools save you hours of work, $10 to $20 a month can be a bargain, especially if you actually finish that project you've been putting off. Now that said, there are also limitations. Most tools work great if you're starting a new project, but things get trickier with large code bases. Slow response time and poor understanding of existing code can be a real problem. And let's not forget, if the AI isn't properly guided and the code generated is not reviewed, it can generate buggy or even insecure code. For enterprise-level applications, cleaning that up might cost more than it saves. There's no official benchmark or rating system, so my best advice is to try two or three tools for a use case and see what works best. These tools are evolving fast. What doesn't work today might be amazing in a month from now. So stay up to date, hit that subscribe button if you haven't done that yet, and thank you for watching. Let me know what you think in the comments below.